Hey everyone, Brady from Texturelabs.org here. In this video, we're gonna get a little ambitious with Photoshop, a little bit experimental, and we're gonna create this waveform depth scan effect. This is gonna be a simple but clever little Photoshop action, an action being a set of steps that we record in the program, and then we can just hit the play button and Photoshop will perform those steps automatically. So with this action, we can create that Joy Division album cover effect, or if we really lean into it, we can create these kind of wireframe looking wave scans of images. Now, when I say this is gonna be a simple action, what I mean is it doesn't have a lot of steps in it. This is the entire action we're gonna build. But conceptually, I do think it's a little more advanced, a little more interesting. That's the kind of stuff I think is the most fun. So we're gonna build the action, but I also want to explain how it works along the way. Once it's built, that's kind of half the battle. We gotta figure out how to use it to create some cool imagery. So we'll talk a little bit about depth and about depth maps. That's the plan. Let's get started just by trying to clarify what is it that we are trying to get the program to do. Well, the goal is this. We want to take a source image and we want to create a bunch of little rows of white pixels, little white stripes. And we want to distort or displace those stripes based on how light or dark the corresponding rows in the image are. And that should give us this visual representation, almost like a graph of the light and dark values in the image. So I think the first instinct in Photoshop is to take a layer with a bunch of stripes and use the displace filter, give it some vertical displacement, and use the original image as the displacement map. But that doesn't really give us what we're looking for. And it really comes down to how the displace filter works, because while it might seem like this is an effect like liquify that will move values from one place to another, it might be more accurate to think of displace as being like the clone tool, which instead is making copies of values from one place to another. Let's take a look at just a small section here. So we have our image that's getting displaced and we have our displacement map, and each of the pixels in the map has a light or dark value. So for simplicity's sake, let's just say these values are measured from negative 10 to positive 10 with 50% gray being zero. The displace filter is gonna take the values from the map and apply them to each corresponding pixel. And the effect will say, for this pixel, lose the original value and instead make a copy of the pixel that's five pixels down. This one, lose the original value and make a copy of the pixel that's three pixels down. This one, two pixels up. This one is zero, so it stays the same, etc., etc. Each pixel is just replaced with the pixel that's X distance away. So this does have the effect of distorting the image, but you might end up with multiple copies of the same pixel. You might end up with no copies of a particular pixel. And on a larger scale, that's why we're ending up with an effect that has these kind of weird loops and shapes in it. Around here, there were a bunch of values in the displacement map that all happened to point to that original row of pixels that was the white line. Over here, it just so happened that none of the values pointed to that row, so we get no white values. So instead, how can we take each of these white pixels and just move it up or down? Well, we are gonna use the displace filter, but we're gonna have to be a little bit more clever about it. And the way this is gonna work is gonna require a particular setup, a particular starting point in our document. It's gonna look like this. First of all, this document is 2000 pixels high. That seems to be a scale that kind of works well with the displace filter. And then we're gonna need four layers, a layer called depth, and this is gonna control the height of the waveforms. This can be anything, but maybe just to get started, I'll use some render clouds. We also need a layer called color. This is gonna determine the color of the waveform lines. Maybe they're just white, maybe there's something colorful, but separating the depth and the color you'll see does end up being useful. On top of that, we need a layer that's filled with solid black. Black is my foreground color, so I can just use Option Delete. And one more layer, this layer just needs to have a single row of white pixels. And the marquee tool actually has an option to select a single row, and then I can fill it with white, which happens to be my background color, so I can use Command Delete. Then this document needs to be saved, and I'm gonna save it as wavetemplate.psd. Now to get started, this single row of white pixels is the layer that I need to have selected. Then I'm gonna open up the Actions panel because we are now ready to create this action. In the Actions panel, I'm gonna hit this little plus to create a new action. Let's call it Depth Waves. And by default, we are now recording the action. So I need to be very careful just only to do these exact steps. If I move things or select different layers, the action will try to record that as well. So just these specific steps. First, I'm gonna Alt or Option click on the eyeball to solo this layer out. So it's a little hard to see, but just this one white stripe is visible at the moment. Then I'm gonna use Image Trim. And with default settings, which is transparent pixels and trim away everything, that cropped the image down to just that one row. Okay, now I'm gonna Option or Alt click on the eye next to the depth layer, and that will solo out the depth layer instead. Then I'm gonna hit Command or Control S to save. Okay, so now keep in mind that we now have a saved image called wavetemplate.psd that's just the single row of pixels from the depth layer. But in our document here, we need to back up out of this crop. And the undo command doesn't always work well with actions, so instead I'm gonna open the history panel. And this is our current state. I'm gonna go two steps back, which should be the layer visibility command, and click on that. And that should register in the action as history state -2, which is the equivalent of hitting undo twice. And meanwhile, the saved image is still this single row of pixels. Then I'm gonna option or alt click on this eyeball again to unsolo this white stripe layer. Okay, next I'm gonna hit Command or Control C to copy this white stripe layer. You can imagine that's placing this clean straight line on our clipboard. Then I'm gonna give this white stripe layer its color from the color layer. So to do that, I'm gonna go into the image menu and use Apply Image. Under the source layer, I'm gonna point it to the layer called color. And this is important, I need to turn on the preserve transparency box. Okay, so that just replaced the white color with the colors from the color layer, but preserve transparency means it didn't add any pixels, it's still a single row of pixels. And then finally, we get to use the displace filter. I'm gonna set it to 0 on the horizontal and 100 on the vertical, and I wanna be sure that stretch to fit is selected. Then it's gonna ask us for a file to use as the displacement map, and we're gonna use the wavetemplate.psd file, that single stripe, as the displacement map. Now, because the displace effect is using stretch to fit, this single row displacement map is getting stretched to become a displacement map that looks like this, long columns of single values. So what would that look like in terms of displacement numbers? Well, every pixel in this column is basically gonna get offset by 4 pixels. Every pixel in this column by 3 pixels. So the displace filter is effectively gonna offset each entire column up or down a discrete number of pixels, meaning no duplicate pixels, no missing pixels. Each column is just getting modified up or down. So we end up with a nice smooth wave, just for this one section though, just for this row. So next what we're gonna do is merge this single wave down onto the solid black layer. That's gonna be Command or Control E to merge down. Every wave we make is just gonna get merged down into this layer. This is where we're like printing the waves to. So remember that clean line is still on the clipboard. So the next step is gonna be to paste it back in, but not just a regular paste, we want paste in place. Command or Control Shift V. Regular paste will just put that line right in the middle of the document. Paste in place has pasted it right back where we found it. However, we're gonna wanna create the next waveform down. So the final step in this action is gonna be to move the line down 30 pixels. I'm gonna use Command or Control T to transform, and I'm just going up to the Y axis and adding 30 to this value. Hit return, and that's it. That's the whole action. I can hit the stop button, and let's try this action out. I'm just gonna hit the play button. Looks good, we get the next row down. Hit it again, we get the next row. Again, we get the next row. And if we could watch this in slow motion, the action is soloing out the stripe, cropping the image, soloing the depth layer, saving the image, backing out of the crop, revealing the other layers, copying the line to the clipboard, applying the color from the color layer, displacing based on the currently saved image, merging this new wave down, pasting in the clean wave, moving it down 30 pixels, and it's ready for the next wave. So all we've got to do is just keep running the action, and each play only takes a moment, so it's kind of fun to watch the image come together, and we've got our whole scan. Now, since the action is set up to displace based on this file, wavetemplate.psd, we can use this file kind of like a template. We can just swap out the color and depth layers and just kind of scan whatever we want here. So let's get rid of this depth layer and try it with something different. I'm gonna take this skull and copy and paste it in as a layer called depth, and then maybe we'll just make the color solid white here. I'm gonna reset the solid black layer that we're kind of printing to by just filling it with solid black again, move the little scanner stripe to the top, and run this action. All right, so that's working. It's giving us kind of an interesting image, and it's basically giving us this visual representation of where the light and dark values are in the image. You can sort of make out the skull, but obviously the waveforms don't wrap around the contours of the skull, because if we wanted the waves to wrap around the skull, then what we would need is a depth map of this skull image. Now, a depth map is a type of image you'll be familiar with if you do any work in 3D space. It's just a totally different kind of image where the light and dark values don't represent the color colors or the shadows of a subject. The light and dark values only represent how near or far away something is to us. And a depth map is traditionally something that was pretty much only done by modeling something in 3D and then rendering a depth map, because it's not at all how we see the world. And so it's very, very hard to paint a depth map with accurate proportions. But there are a few ways to artificially generate a pretty decent depth map. One of them is right here in Photoshop. It's just a little bit hard to find. What we can do is select this skull layer and go into our neural filters menu and find the depth blur filter. You may need to download it from the cloud, which is pretty quick, but let's turn on depth blur. And here's the trick. You're gonna wanna make sure focus subject is turned off, and then scroll down and turn output depth map only, turn that on. And that is going to give us a depth map. Not a super detailed one, but a pretty decent depth map. Photoshop has made the darker colors represent items nearest to us, and this should be the other way around. So let's invert this. Then I'm gonna call this layer depth and rename the previous image layer so it doesn't get used by the action. Then let's reset the black layer and the white line layers and run through this action a handful of times and see what we end up with. Okay, so now the lighter the depth map is, or the nearer things are to us, the higher the waves are gonna go. So it starts to almost create this illusion of like a 3D wireframe. Of course, we don't have a whole lot of detail here. Let's try one more thing. What I'm gonna do now is use that same depth map as the depth layer, but this time use the original skull image as the color layer. So depth and color, and let's see what that does. All right, that I think is a very, very cool effect. Not only does it give us our original black background on kind of the edges of the waves, but by giving those little waveforms just a little bit of shading, I think it helps to create just enough detail that we can really make out the image. Now you might notice that between the original image and our new effect, the perspective seems to have changed, and we're now looking at the skull from a slightly different angle, which is kind of strange. You definitely get bonus points if you already have a sense of why that's happening. The reason for that is this: if we had all these lines and they didn't get displaced at all, they didn't curve at all, we'd have a skull that matches the original image. But by curving the lines based on their depth, we've basically simulated tilting the entire subject back a little bit. So kind of an interesting thing to keep in mind. All right, let's do one more depth scan. What about using an image of a living person's head? Well, we could try to generate a depth map using this guy's face, and I will say Photoshop doesn't generally pick up a whole lot of detail and depth maps of people's faces, but a few things I've found that can help. What I'll do is kind of process the image to try to make it a little bit easier for the neural filter to interpret. A little bit of trial and error is involved, but generally trying to remove as much noise as possible, making sure it's got a nice healthy amount of contrast. A lot of the time getting rid of the color altogether can actually help, and by putting the subject on just a plain black background, I want to try to get the depth blur to focus on what's important and give us the depth where we want it. So a depth map of this guy is going to look like this. Let's invert it and even crank up the contrast and just see how much detail we can get. Not too bad, right? Now, I feel like I do have to mention, I'm not the biggest fan of the way some of the AI image generators were created or how they might be getting put to use, but it is true that Stable Diffusion can do a pretty great job at generating artificial depth maps. Maybe that's a little bit less ethically questionable use of the software. I don't know. If that's something you're interested in getting into, it's sort of a whole different project to learn about. It's not something I'm particularly interested in doing on the Texturelabs channel, but let it be said that Stable Diffusion is also a way to generate depth maps. I do recognize that this Photoshop depth map is pretty much created using the same kind of technology, but I appreciate that Adobe is at least claiming to be doing this without infringing on copyrights, which makes a pretty big difference. In any case, let's try taking these two layers, copy-pasting them into the template. I'll scale them down to fit, and I'm just gonna move these layers to be the very bottom layers. When the action looks for a layer called depth and a layer called color, it's gonna start looking at the bottom, and it's gonna use the first depth layer or color layer that it finds on the way up. Then I can reset the black layer, filling it with black again, move the little white line back to the top, and try out this action. Okay, we've got a pretty decent head scan happening here. Now, I think what would be really cool is if we could scan the back of his head too, but we obviously don't have a depth map of the back of his head. We could try to fake one, but honestly, I think the shortest route here is just to make some fake scan lines. So let's just create some straight lines. In order to make them the same distance apart, I'm just gonna make a depth map that's solid gray and a fill color that's solid gray. Then I'm gonna create a new layer for these scan lines to stack up in. This time I'm not gonna fill it with black. These scan lines will just print to this empty layer. And since the depth and the color are just solid gray, we get straight lines. Then I'm going to set this layer to screen mode and Command-T transform. Maybe give them some warp distortion to kind of bend them in the right direction. See if we can push the perspective to be at least in the right neighborhood, something like that. And then I'm just going to paint some black to get rid of the extra lines on the edges. Pretty simple, but I think if we bring down the opacity and make these more of a subtle addition, I think it creates a pretty decent illusion. So that's basically how this idea works. From here, we can, you know, give things some glow effects or some color tone, or even start to mix and match different elements. I hope you guys enjoy experimenting with this effect. Always more on the way from the Texturelabs channel. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.